Day 4 comes to a close here in Guangzhou. There you see the main bus terminal, a busy place. And there is Kia Champions Field in Guangzhou. In today's highlights, men's synchro 10-meter platform diving. We'll have multiple events out at rowing. Archery individual and team competitions continue. We'll have gymnastics apparatus finals for both men and women. Judo individual competition finishes up here. We'll head to the pool for some sprint swimming action. Australia takes on Japan in basketball. Taekwondo gets going here for the first time in Guangzhou. And fencing team competition takes place here on day 4. There you have a nice aerial view of the Nambu University Aquatic Center here in Guangzhou. We're now ready for the men's synchronized 10-meter platform final. We'll take a look here at the Russian pair of Igor Galperin and Igor Mialin. They're attempting a back 3.5 somersault in the tuck position. That had a difficulty of 3.3. You can see pretty solid synchronization. A little bit of splash on the entry, but that'll score them 83.16. Now to the Korean pair of Kim Jin-yong and Kim Yong-nam. This is a back 2.5 somersault with 2.5 twists in the pike position. A difficulty of 3.6. Another angle here of that dive. Some splash on the entry, but they will score 86.40. Kim Jin-yong won a bronze in the 3-meter synchro event already here at Universiade. Now the Chinese pair of Wang Anki and Wang Yao. A 3.5 somersault in the pike position. Some splash there on the entry. We'll get a good look here at pretty solid synchronization as they hit the water. And they will score 87.48, much to the delight of the Chinese fans in attendance. And they'll be really delighted at this, a gold medal for Wang and Wang. Kim and Kim take silver, while Galperin and Mialin take bronze. A bit of an overcast day greets the rowers here at the Chungju Tangiam Lake. We'll take a look now at the women's double sculls. There you see the start list. In lane 4 are the defending double sculls champions from the 2013 World Rowing Championships. And as you can see there, they cross well in front here to take a gold medal in front of the team from Ukraine. And a very close finish for third. It'll be the Belarusian team that ultimately is given the medal, as you can see there from the final results. But in first place, it's Vistertaitė and Valkiuchaitė of Lithuania. Now the men's double sculls. And as we saw in the women's, a strong Lithuanian team here. And there you see that crew powering away to an easy win. They won silver at the 2013 World Rowing Championships at this very venue in Korea. In second place it's Poland, and third is Germany. And there you see the crew from Lithuania, Rolandis Machinskis and Sulius Ritter, in a time of 6 minutes, 3.76 seconds. Moving on now to the women's lightweight single sculls. And there you see out in lane 1, that is Wang Miao of China. She wins gold, another Lithuanian medal, this time a silver for Sanada Petrikaitė. And in third, Caroline Franske of Germany, the bronze. Wang in a time of 7 minutes, 31.65 seconds to win gold. And last up, this is the men's lightweight single sculls. There you see Jerzy Kowalski of Poland in lane three. He will win gold. A good battle there for silver. Toby Cuncliffe-Steele of New Zealand will win it. And Bense Thomas of Hungary, he will claim bronze. And Kowalski will better his silver medal performance from Kazan in 2013, winning gold here in Guangzhou. Archery competition continues here in Guangzhou, the Guangzhou International Archery Center, the site. First up, the compound mixed team gold medal match. Here you see Song and Kim of Korea. And they are taking on Venom and Singh of India. 118-112 heading into the fourth and final end. This Korean duo set a Universiade record earlier on in qualification. And India trying to keep pace with the Koreans. They score a 9 there. That'll put them at 150. That's what Korea has to beat. And right there, that will do it. That's enough. Korea wins this gold medal match, 157-150, to take the gold medal. India wins silver. Now to the compound men's individual. Kim Jong-ho taking on Kim Tae-yoon. These two teamed up earlier to win gold in the men's compound competition. We now look on in the fifth end. Kim Jong-ho there with a score of 9. And this one will be close right to the end. We see a score of 145 for Kim Tae-yoon. Kim Jong-ho now trying to beat that, and he will. It'll be gold and silver for Korea. Kim Jong-ho with the gold. Kim Tae-yoon wins silver. And now the compound women's individual gold medal match. Song Yoon-soo taking on Toya Cherne of Slovenia. There you see the score through the fourth end. There you see a perfect 10 from Song. And now Cherne, she will score a 9. So we're tied again at 134. Now Cherna needing to equal that last score from Song. As these two continue this battle. And it will be tied. We will head to a shoot-off. And in that shoot-off, it will be Song Yoon-soo. She wins gold. Toya Cherna of Slovenia silver, and Stephanie Salinas of Mexico will win the bronze medal. It's the final day of artistic gymnastics at the Guangzhou Universiade, the Guangzhou Women's University, the site. The apparatus finals. Look at the men's floor exercise. This is Naoto Hayasaka of Japan. He's battling with Oleg Vernayev of Ukraine, who won gold yesterday in the men's all-around and had the second best score on floor in that all-around competition. And Hayasaka is thrilled with that performance. Get a good look at one of the passes there, and just right at the end, you can see that joy on his face. Score of 15.666. He will finish first, Oleg Vernayev second, and a tie for third between Shogo Nonomura of Japan and Marco Walter of Switzerland. Now the women's vault. Here is Maria Paseka of Russia. won a gold in the women's team competition as the defending bronze medalist in this event. She also won bronze in the 2012 London Olympics. Good look at that first vault of hers there. Little bit of a step there on the landing. But nonetheless, a good score, 14.750. She will win gold. Kelly Sim of Great Britain wins silver, and Daria Elizarova of Russia, the bronze. Now the men's pommel horse. This is Donathan Bailey of the United States. He won a bronze in the team competition at the 2011 Pan American Games and scored 14.350 on the pommel horse during the team competition here in Guangzhou. Prepares for his dismount. Nicely done. Happy with that performance. A 14.766 for him. And he will knock off Naoto Hayasaka, who already won gold, as you saw earlier in the men's floor exercise. There are the final results. Akash Modi of the United States wins the bronze. Next up, the women's uneven bars. And here is Ekaterina Kramarenko of Russia. Competed in the team all-around back at the 2008 Olympics in Beijing. And already has a gold medal to her credit here in Guangzhou from the women's team competition earlier in the games. Sticks that dismount very well. You get a good look at one of the turns there. And there, a good look at the dismount. Landed very well, as I said. Score of 14.800. She will win her second gold medal here in Guangzhou. Asuka Teramoto will win the silver. She won that in both the team and individual all around. And then Maria Paseka picks up another medal, the bronze. Finally now, the men's rings. This is Artur Tovmasyan of Armenia. Finished sixth of the European Championships early this year in Montpellier, France. He's up against Igor Radivilov of Ukraine, who won the bronze in this event back at Kazan. Very good performance. The Armenian fans are excited about that one. Very calm, as you can see there, as he holds that one position. A little bit of a step on the landing, but a good score of 15.500. Enough for gold. Radivilov of Ukraine will take silver, and Oleg Vernayev wins another medal, this time a bronze here in the men's rings. Individual judo competition wraps up here today at the Yeomju Bitgul Gymnasium in Guangzhou. Women's under 48 kilogram class, this is Jeong Bokyong of Korea taking on Gabriela Chibana of Brazil. Jeong in white won a European Open event in Prague in February of this year, and Chibana in blue. She finished second in two Pan American Open events last season. The Korean there scores a Wazaari, and time will tick down. And that Wazaari will stand up to give her the gold medal. Chibana takes silver. Funatanaki of Japan and Urantsetseg Mukbat of Mongolia each take bronze. Moving on to the men's under 60 kilogram class, Kim Won-jin of Korea in white and Yuma Oshima of Japan in blue. Kim is a two-time Universiade medalist, having won gold in Shenzhen and a bronze in Kazan. Also won a world championship bronze in 2013 in Rio de Janeiro. Oshima is a former world under 21 bronze medalist. Time ticking down here. The one yuko on the board for the Korean, and it looks like that's going to stand up. That will give him a gold medal on home soil. Kim Won-jin, gold. Yuma Oshima, silver. Philippe Pilim of Brazil and Albert Ogazov of Russia take bronze. The women's open competition, Kim Ji-yoon of Korea and Kang Ji of China. Kang in white, Kim in blue. Kang won a bronze earlier at Universiade in the over 78 kilogram class. But this time it'll be silver she has to settle for. Kim Ji-yoon with Ippon wins here in the women's open class. Alexandra Babinseva of Russia and Sari Yamamoto of Japan will win bronze. And there you see Kim, and a replay here of the Ippon that gives her the gold medal. And finally, the men's open gold medal match. This bout features Yuhan Metis of Estonia and Katsuma Ueda of Japan. Metis is in blue, Ueda in white. Metis was fifth in the men's over 100 kilogram class earlier here at Universiade. One yuko on the board already for the Japanese judoka. You can see that time ticking up. If he can hold Metis down, he'll score again, and he does. Another yuko. And those two yukos, as time winds down, enough to give Katsuma Ueda a gold medal. Metis takes silver. Bauza of Lithuania and Simonescu of Romania each take bronze. Swimming action continues at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. We get a look inside. We get ready for the women's 400 meter freestyle. In lane four, Leah Smith of the United States. She set a Universiade record earlier in the day in the heats in a time of 4 minutes, 4.66 seconds. And she continues on that strong pace. Won't break her record again, but she will win a gold medal. In first place ahead of Lindsay Vrooman of the United States. And third, it's Martina Demem of Italy. She is the defending gold medalist in this event from Kazan. Vrooman also won a silver earlier in the week in the 1500 meters. She adds to that collection here today. Second gold for Smith. She won one in the 4x200 meter freestyle relay. Now the women's 200 meter individual medley. Look for Madison Cox in lane four. She won a gold in the 4x200 meter relay. And then Zhang Cixi in lane five. And it is those two coming down to the wall. And Zhang touches just ahead of Cox and Fullerton of Australia to win a gold medal for China. In a time of 2 minutes, 12.31 seconds, Madison Cox wins the silver, and Ellen Fullerton of Australia will take the bronze medal. Now the men's 200 meter breaststroke final. This features Josh Pernot in lane six. He won a gold in a tie in the 200 meter individual medley. And Craig Harry Benson of Great Britain in lane four, he won a bronze in the 100 meter breaststroke. Really, really close between the three in the middle lanes there. And it'll be Pernot again winning. Very close, 18 one-hundredths of a second ahead of Kazuki Koinada of Japan to win his second gold medal of the games. And he is excited. Koinada takes silver, and Benson will add to his collection of bronze with this one in the 200 meter breaststroke. Now a sprint, the 50 meter backstroke for men. Junya Hasegawa in lane four won the gold medal in the 100 meter backstroke. He is in lane four. Stefano Pizzamiglio of Italy in lane six. And Nikita Yulianov of Russia in lane three. And as sprints go, it is tight right down to the wall and a big push here at the end. And Hasegawa wins his second gold in a time of 25.25 seconds. 18 one-hundredths ahead of Pizzamiglio of Italy. And Yulianov of Russia is 24 one-hundredths back in third spot. And there you see the three medalists in the men's 50-meter backstroke. This concludes the medals awarding ceremony. Australia takes on Japan in men's Group C basketball action at the Gwangju University Gymnasium. Both teams 1-1 coming into this game. We'll jump to the fourth quarter. 57-52, Australia leading Japan. There's Nagayoshi knocking down a jumper for the Japanese. There is Keanu Pinder with a layup for Australia. And now Yudi Baba with a shot fake, and he knocks down that jumper. Next, we'll look here. Sean Bruce to Daniel Trist. That one's followed up by Dang Dang. Nice bit of passing there by the Australians. Another great pass there. You see Vendrame to Nagayoshi. He misses it, but then Hariyama follows up with the rebound and the finish. Now the Aussies back. That's Mitchell Creek, and that one will just fall home. Nice little runner there with the left hand. And now Mitchell McCarron will step back, and he'll knock down the three-pointer. Fans liking this one. Now McCarron again, showing he can do it inside. Takes the contact and knocks that one in off the glass. Now Keanu Pinder, that's a nice take, won't fall. But Mathiang will finish it up. Mathiang ended up with 11 points and 14 rebounds for Australia. There's a nice pass ahead. Yuma Fuji finds Yudai Baba, and he'll finish. Baba had 13 points and 6 rebounds for the Japanese. Nice finish there. Corey Maynard to Mitchell Creek. Then Creek again, that one won't fall. But stolen back by Hugh Greenwood. Nice spin there in the left hand. Greenwood led Australia with 19 points. And in the end, Australia will move to 2-1 with a 73-58 win over Japan. The Japanese fall to 1-2. They will take on Lithuania next. Australia takes on Finland.
Men's and women's individual Pumse final competitions were held at Joseon University Gymnasium Mat 2. Pumse is the continuous operation of the basic techniques of attack and defense and connection in Taekwondo. This is men's individual Pumse final. The two predetermined Pumse for this competition are Taebaek and Pyeongwon. The method of scoring includes 5 points of accuracy and 5 points of presentation, thus the total score of 10. Bae Jong-bum from Republic of Korea won a gold medal with a total score of 7.93. A silver medal went to Jamal Lee from Iran, and the bronze medal for Heidi from Indonesia. Now this is women's individual Pumse final. The two predetermined Pumse for this competition are Geum Gang and Taebaek. The gold medalist Yang Han-sol from Republic of Korea is performing Geum Gang and Taebaek Pumse. This Geum Gang Pumse expresses solidness and strength of a nature. This is Taebaek Pumse. Taebaek is a name of mountains in Korea. The performer is supposed to show the lesson he learned from Taebaek Mountain. Yang won a gold medal with a total score of 7.67. Therefore, Republic of Korea obtained 2 gold medals in men's and women's Taekwondo today. More competitions will be held tomorrow.
Team fencing competition from the Kim Dae-jung Convention Center in Gwangju. First up, the men's saber team final featuring Ukraine and France. The Ukraine team is Yevgeny Stetsenko, Yuri Tsap, and Bogdan Platonov. And for France, it is Tom Seitz, Maxence Lambert, and Arthur Zatko. 9-6 right now. This is Lambert and Tsap against each other. France with a 10-6 lead after the first two matches. There another point scored for France. Now tied at 14, this is Zatko and Platonov. Putting the Ukrainians up there 15-14 after three bouts. Very close throughout here between Ukraine and France. Now Seitz and Platonov. Platonov finished 18th in the individual saber competition, while Seitz was 29th. Now the final duo, it's Lambert and Stetsenko. Stetsenko trying to keep Ukraine alive. One more point for the Frenchman and they will win. You can see the sword of Stetsenko go flying, as do their hopes. France wins the gold medal 45-42 over Ukraine. Korea will claim bronze here in the men's saber team competition. There you see the Frenchmen celebrating their victory. And now the women's épée team final. Russia against France. Russian fencers Yulia Lekagina, Elena Komarova, and Victoria Kuzmenkova. And for France, it's Hélène Nome, Dimodi Laurence Epée, and Josephine Jacques-André Coquin. And this one will have a rematch of the gold medal match in the women's individual épée, which featured Kuzmenkova and Dimodi Laurence Epée. Epée won that to claim the gold. ...26-17, and here is part of that rematch, Epée and Kuzmenkova. France with a commanding lead right now. We'll now move on to Jacques-André Coquin and Komarova. Russia trying to stay in and trying to work their way back. Now the final pair. This is Epée and Lekagina. As mentioned, Epée won the gold in the individual. Lekagina won bronze. Nice attack there from Epée. 1 point away from gold. But Lekagina not going away. Scores one there, 44-38. And there, that will win it for France. A gold medal in the women's épée team competition. Russia takes silver, and the United States will win a bronze medal.